Namaste everyone, happy morning and warm cordial welcome to one and all to this day 4 webinar on personal development program for college students organized by Department of Biotechnology under the banner of Tanzanic Club KLU Societies S Nijalingappa College Bengaluru. I'm Dr. Pratibha KS, Head Department of Biotechnology. It gives me great privilege to welcome you all to this today's fourth webinar session on goal setting and creativity. Any occasion needs divine blessings of the Lord Almighty. Let us seek the divine grace of Lord. Saraswati Namastubhyam Varade Kamarupini Vidya Rambam Karishyami Siddhir Bhavatume Sada. Today I am very much delighted to see you all here. This webinar has been organized in order to share insights of goal settings and creativity skills. Dear students, we have amongst us an eminent enriched speaker, Mr. Amarnath J, a well-known personality development trainer. Now, I would like to welcome Mr. Amarnath J for accepting our invitation. Welcome to this webinar, sir.
Thank you. Good morning.
Thank you, sir, for gracing this moment. We always keep coming to you with wonderful opportunity. I'm really glad to have with us Amarnath J to share his views on goal setting and creativity skills to make our young, energetic, dynamic youths to be more conscious in this competitive world. The sole aim of today's webinar is to know and to understand about the goal setting and creativity skills. With this brief note, I would like to request Mr. Amarnath J, sir, to take control over today's session on goal settings and creativity skill. Over to you, sir.
Thank you very much. Warm good morning to everyone. So yesterday, the last slide you have seen, that is sky is the limit. So when the sky is the limit, that you know your strength. Today, we will understand about the two areas what you are supposed to know. The characteristics of the goal that you have set for yourself, and you should also understand the key areas of the organization where you are going to be after your study. You may start your own entrepreneurship, whatever may be. The goal setting should be very effective and it should be of the characters that should challenge you. So first let us take what is called as a challenging. Challenge means it should be in a realistic way. In English we use the word I can do and I could do it. I can do is always a permanent ability. I could do it once in a way that I was able to do it. So this can, you can, I can, we can. This is very important for us to understand the situation. So your goal should be realistic and also suited to your present capabilities. Present capabilities, what you are, and also in future, what you want to be. That is what we have mentioned whenever you set your goals, the dream. So the dream should give you the strength and also the way that you take action, that is also very important. So action is important, your dream is big and your actions are also accordingly. Your behavior and the target that you have set for yourself, once it is very clear, the success is very much assured. With that, the challenging, it should test your strength and it should become very clear what really I want to achieve myself. Once that is clear, you will be able to attain it in a given time. So in a given time, where you want to reach, the goal is very far? No. If you can think it, what is your midterm goal? And also short-term goal. It should be attainable. Make sure you can actually achieve what you are setting out to do. Otherwise, there will be a sort of a frustration. That means it should be attainable at all the time. Rather thinking that I'm going to do today 60 minutes exercise first with a short-term goal, 30 minutes, you'll be successful. That will give that enthusiasm, you stretch yourself according to your potential. And one should be very specific. Specific in the sense, giving 100%. not even 99.99 is not acceptable. It is 100% and you have to become better. So the software for success, it will make it very clear. You have to do your work and you have to do a little more also. And overall development should be there. It should be very, very measurable and the action steps should be very clear. You should guide yourself and emotionally you need to balance and keep a track of yourself, write your own progress so that you can understand how the time that is limited. Here, time, it is always the same. It is your present moment, how best you are making use of it. That should be very realistic. Short-term goal to achieve your today's task, how you are going to take it forward very effectively, that is very important. Once your short-term goal should lead to mid-term goal, that is a day's work that should take you do well in your test, do well in your exam. Naturally, your mid-term goal, your graduation, the knowledge that you are going to have, and also the experience you are going to have. Once you are very clear, and you should also have a checkpoints. Checkpoints in the sense you should keep regularly reviewing yourself. Anything that is significant, if you observe, that keeps on motivating. So you are challenging yourself, it should be attainable, it should be very clear, specific, and time, 24 hours, how effectively you will make use of it. And you should have always the positive attitude. Positive attitude is you can visualize yourself and you can understand the time frame that you have allotted. Humans are designed, you know, there is a perfect. If you can see the computers, you know what are all the best computers that are available in the market. Before that, you should also think that your computer, your brain is made by the great eminent engineer that got. Its capacity is very high. Only thing, we need to realize it. Example, let us take, I want to avoid my junk food. If I want to avoid my junk food, this is only promising yourself, but still the taste will be keep tempting. And in your positive attitude, you visualize yourself, an apple keeps the doctor away. Then you think that apple, how it is good, the fruits. This should become a higher taste. So it should give the positive note, the flow of energy, and also the zeal that you carry. Once you are specific with your positive attitude, you also need to be flexible. Flexible in the sense how you should manage your emotion or any stress management, whatever it is there. Good strategies and goals are always, it should be very clear to you. Because nothing in this world stays the same for a very long time. And staying alive and on the course means being able to adapt yourself in the changing circumstance is very, very important. You can see yourself. Winston Churchill says, once you set the goal, at the end of the work, you should also give a positive note for yourself. Yes, I am that this day, from this day, now. I have successfully completed the task that I have taken up, which also motivates for you further. And once you understand about yourself, the characteristics of all the goals that you have taken up, now we will also understand what are the key organizational goals. Next slide, please. Next slide. Okay. Next slide. Now you can see the target. I hope you remember when you see the target, Arjuna. And how he looked at the target. There's a famous quote, a Napoleon Hill, whatever the mind conceives, you have got the ability to do it. A, B, C. A is your ability, B is what you believe, and also C is confusion. Even Lord Buddha says, whatever it goes into the mind, you are going to become like that. Even Swami Vivekananda says, be fearless. See your target at all the time. Be like Arjuna. You know, once you are an Arjuna, you will also understand what are the key areas of an organization. So Peter Drucker, a most, you know, well-respected person, he says, the very first thing is an organization aims for the market share. We always, we say we are the brand leaders, we claim ourselves. So here what is very important, the market share, it is concerned with enhancing market share. That will make you comfortable. That will give you the confidence you are doing the right work in the right direction. So 25% of the sales, what are the products it is? New products should keep on entering. So this is a scenario that you are going to be once you complete your education. And when you know the goal that you have set for yourself and the goals that an organization wants to achieve through your contribution, you can understand the step to what is called as a productivity. This is probably the most often cited goal of all. So greater outcomes with a fewer input. This will be always what the organization looks forward. As productivity increases, market share goal can be pursued even by dropping the price. That means the number of units they need to sell and also the profit when they calculate. If they are able to sell in a bigger volume, then the cost will be automatically, it will be reduced. Market share and productivity, for that, an organization will think of their physical and financial resources. Physical resource is a human resource, and a financial resource is the what they can invest for the products, the cost of production, in other way to think. So increasing the cash flow is often very important for any new venture. The next step is the profitability they will always look forward. This is usually expressed as a percentage and should always be stated. Profitability, it helps the organization to expand and also get into new ventures also. The next step is the management performance and development. Management training is important because management is the key to organization success. Example, let us take GE, General Electrical, has a special course where they conduct for their employees, for young managers. So 15 days training, as often as it is required. This will give them a better management practice. This is often neglected in so many organizations. You know, a leading company, always they will be very clear about the skills that is required by the employees. Accordingly, they will plan and also a resource is set apart from the even the it may be the machineries that they want to buy, and even human resource management, that also should go hand in hand. When we look to the next steps, the employees' performance and attitude goals. Employees are most important asset in any organization, although many organizations don't act as if they believe it. See here, that self-confidence. You know, once they appoint an employee, they need to know that when exactly they should train again. Because the performance standard, the objects that we set, we always keep raising our performance standard. And organization, you can see, to name a few, Infosys, Wipro, L&T, and any organization, they have got certain social responsibilities also. So for social responsibilities, they have to keep an eye on that. And these days, we can witness the organization providing matching funds for fundraising efforts and giving their employees a certain number of paid hours, time off, to keep their attitude towards the organization. They say, you know, leave travel allowance or the number of days paid leave. So all these things, now you can be very clear what an organization is looking forward from you and what you should look forward from you. There was a question asked by Arjuna to Krishna. One side you are telling that the knowledge is important and another side you are forcing me to do the work. The answer is, in your study days, it is the knowledge path. Path of knowledge is what you have chosen. So the knowledge should make you free from reaction, and also the action path. Action path, you can see, it should be backed up by knowledge. So one is you should have a freedom. That means you are free from reaction, and also you will achieve the expected, the talent and the skill development is also required. So knowledge is important, Sankhya Yoga, and action, Karma Yoga, that will help you to reach to a perfection free from reaction. Next slide, please. Okay. Now we should understand long-term goals and short-term goals, mid-term goals. These three words, let us keep on repeating so that we will understand its significance. Long-term goals are the goals where you have to work backwards. Think about what you want to achieve, then plan the steps going back to what you can do right now. So, my 25th birthday, what I should be. It is only a mid-term goal. Long-term goal is much beyond that. And for that, what I should do in a month or in a 6 months, a semester, or a month, and even a week, and today, and right now. So this is backward coming to understand what is my long-term goal. Create a picture of where you want to be in life 10 years now. So 10 years now, 2030, what you want to be, and today, what you need to do. Once that is clear, your work will give you that energy. The reason is, unless that health and energy, if you see, always you should feel the energy and the health is, never I had this sort of a zeal, never I had this sort of energy. Education and also your activities will give you this sort of feeling. Think about what you need to do in 5 years, in 1 year and 6 months to get to your long-term goal. It is so clearly, it is scheduled. And once it is scheduled, there are multitasking is avoided. When multitasking is avoided, you can be very, very focused. Your long-term goal, you can see that taking a step by step, and also doing your prioritized work. You can visualize the success and also make an inward journey to understand the true potential that it is there. And when you pen down all these things, your diary will give you the right direction, and also your feel-good effect should be there. Every 1 hour, you should feel that I have done a very good work. And after each month, the goal is achieved. Look at your goals and also adjust them as it is needed. One more important thing, my behavior should always match the goal. That is very, very important. Next slide, please. So prioritizing your goals, setting the goal, and also prioritizing, that is very important. That means you have to decide which one you are going to do first and what is the importance of the work that you have taken up and how it is going to contribute towards your goal. So prioritizing, it means that you decide what is very important and also right now and what is my next work, also you are very clear. But it is impossible to work on all of them at once. So that is the reason prioritization will give you the clarity and also it will give you the expected results by the way of knowledge and also by way of action. What is more important right now? Focus mainly on that goal. And additional goal as you become comfortable with your efforts. So effort is important. Along with that, the time also, you know, the significance of the work that you have taken up. Over and above all this, you should also have a flexibility. Because being flexible, it is very important. Change your focus on goals as your life changes. The two possibilities you can see, either it is an ascent or it is a descent. It will never be a static. Once you can understand this, you will be clear about yourself. And we will understand in the next slide how smart you should be. So the smartness, we need to understand how smart we should be. Specific, what exactly is specific? What I want to do, that should be very specific. Measurable, achievable, realistic, and time-based. When you write your goals, that is specific, ask yourself, what I am going to do? And if I am very clear, if that clarity is there and the vivid picture of there in about future, then I will be very clear the health that is required to achieve a specific goal, the energy that I can experience, that becomes very important. A measurable, it means that you are able to determine or figure out what is your target and what is the time that you have allotted for that. If this is very clear, we will be able to understand very easily the time that I am going to take and also the result that I want to achieve. How it should be very realistic. Realistic is all about the time that I am taking, the value that I have created for my work, and how honest I am. Long-term goal, and you can easily go into. So it should be when you write yourself one small steps to complete your goal by the deadlines also. So instead of I am going to lose 10 pounds, a time-based goal, I am going to lose 10 pounds in 2 months, it looks more realistic. And again, thinking that today, what exercise that I should go through. I am going to achieve this within this particular time, and also how this activity of mine, I will be having a better skill after doing this work, the experience that I gain and the results that I am going to achieve and the knowledge that I am going to be, one should be very clear about all these things. And most importantly, I should review. Make it a part of your today to review your goals and take actions accordingly. This keeps your goal always alive and it will be at the top of your mind. It is a good time to convert the plan into an action. The steps that I need to take off, and if at all, if I am taking any emergency work, what is the time that should be allotted? Because giving time for the most prioritized work, that should be at the top of the mind. Next slide, please. So, being very smart, it is very clear that the direction that I am going. So, importance of goal setting, it gives you a very clear focus. Properly thought out and stated goals, clearly set out my intention and desires, it should be very clear. The things you really want to achieve. And in the second step, we can see optimum use of resources. There are never enough resources to do everything. Setting goals can help you to prioritize, place your resources always in the mind and really what you want to achieve rather than on things you are doing by default or by deflection. Knowing the resource, the time that cannot be saved or it cannot be retrieved, I will be very careful whenever I take up the work. And equally important, the feel-good effect also should be there. My involvement should be there. And also my visualization. These things will put together, when you integrate all these things, you are making the best use of the resource that is available. It gives you a very clear picture. You are not only working very effective, you are very effective and effectively also you are doing the work. If you want to improve how you manage the time, stop doing what doesn't need to be done. This is Peter Drucker, the guru of business management. He makes it very clear. Because it is a natural temptation, you know, suppose if there are other works also, if it comes. Without neglecting my prioritized work, how I should take care of those work also, it should be clear. And very importantly, peace of mind. Too often you can have many things on your mind. Writing down your goals can help you to take all those ideas, apply prospectively and priority. That will galvanize you into commitment and also action. So action plan is also there that is properly executed at a given time. Clarity of decision making. Most important thing is when there are so many choices are there in front of me, how I will make my choice is also important. How I believe myself, what is the level of trust that I have got on myself. And once we take care of all these things, the clarity to decision making, knowing what you are trying to do means that you can now ask, does this activity get me closer to my goal? This question should be always, it is there. How my behavior and my action, commitment, my focus will take me closer to the goal. Easy is the comfort level that you have to achieve. Easy doesn't mean the work should be very easy. So easy way of doing is well-composed mind. So more freedom that you will get for your thoughts. Setting the goals, especially the SMART and SHORT goals, allows you to measure how well effectively you are moving towards achieving them. The freedom of thought. As we were discussing, there are 60,000 thoughts, 55,000 repetitive. But here, when the work is very effective, every thought you will also think, is it important or not? So the weak link should be removed in a chain. Setting goals can help to release your creative energies so you can focus on how to achieve them. You will start to look for ways to make it happen. That is what anything that I am doing, it is done twice. First, it should come in the mind, that imaginative, and putting it into action. So there is a blueprint in our mind, and that should be executed in the outer world. Along with that, the most important thing is the communication level. Setting goals enables you to clarify with other people also what you are trying to do and therefore what they need to do to contribute or support. So in a teamwork, this is very important. What I am going to contribute and what is the responsibility of each individual to contribute. See, every unit of work is just like building. The building block is a brick. So the brick, when it comes to the next, when it goes through the process, it is called as a wall. So good communication is very important. Next slide, please. So here we can see how our creativity we can achieve very easily. In the next slide, we can see this. Here you can see the creativity means what you cannot see around you. In your creativity, you can see a very vivid picture, the clarity that you are going to get. So the bulb, it refers the energy when you give. Asatoma sadgamaya, when they say jyotirgamaya, from darkness, tamasoma jyotirgamaya. If you can see yourself very clearly, creative thinking and creative activity is very important. So it is not a mystery. It is only the planned, well-planned work is required. So this creativity is a wonderful concept and it is quite mysterious. For that, we need to put the required effort. There is an art of doing and there is also a science for you to understand. The way we make use. That's why it is, life is called as art and science. The art is the way that you are going to make use of the knowledge that you are having. And scientifically, how logically you will start thinking, just like you are thinking. Logical thinking and reasoning is very important. Creative thinking and creative activity, when you put together, you can see that the new thing. For the first time, you will start experiencing. Your life is that, you know. The present moment will not be there in the next moment. But in this moment, I can also achieve what really I wanted. The skill and also the knowledge level for my next activity. Earlier in the 19th century, they were only thinking, people with high intelligence, they are creative. But not so. Creativity and intelligence, it correlates. Knowledge level is also there and action part is also there. Creativity is the driver. It's a prerequisite to innovative outcome that you want. And also the high performance, the ability to deliver the results that is needed by the client. See, when we are working for the organization, it is the product quality and also the way we serve the clients that are very important. L&T claims, whatever is our research today, tomorrow it is an obsolete, or by the same day evening. That means how they are visualizing themselves. Creativity is not a myth. So creativity is all your efforts and the time that how you are using. There are so many variable factors are also there. Let's take an example of Cafe Coffee Day. So Cafe Coffee Day, Mr. Siddharth, he made it so popular because the concept was something different. Over a cup of coffee, so many things can happen. And there are varieties of coffees he started selling. So how globally he created that brand. And Cafe Coffee Day advertisement also says that, you know, coffee consumption, how he made it popular and the huge success because of the ambience he created. This is most important. The ambience, that is one of the reasons, you know, it is so important to keep our workplace, you know, very, very clean and tidy, because that is going to inspire you. The ambience and the varieties of coffees that he gave, and also economically priced. And we can see some of the people, you know, some important meeting they will also conduct in this Cafe Coffee Day. So using the tagline, so much can happen over a cup of coffee. So this is what I need to think at always. This creativity, it should give a very clear idea. And once this clear idea is there in me, the success can be seen before we start the work itself. That is most important. So here is some of the quotes that we can see, how you can see the new thing. Okay. Creativity is a generalized constellation of intellectual. So in the coming slide, you can see this statement. Next slide, please. The previous one. Please come back. 8th slide. Yes. So the creativity here is a generalized constellation of intellectual ability, the personality variables, and problem-solving triads. So no problem can challenge you because you are much ahead of it. Once you will welcome the problems because you have got the answer. Here it says that problem solving triad is very important in the creativity. A creativity, that is the capacity of a person to product the composition